this video, I will discuss what happens to you when you become an adult. We will talk about the transition process into adulthood. We will talk about the transfer of care. And finally, some recommendations and conclusions. The transition from childhood to mature adulthood is a complex process that doesn't happen with a birthday over one night. This process is now different than it was, for example, 20 years ago, because our society has changed and has become more complex, including climate changes, internet, social media, and increasing peer pressure. Young people's transition to maturity is accompanied by increased levels of instability and risk, which is particularly challenging in people with 22q11 deletion syndrome, because they are already vulnerable. The transition starts with physical changes during puberty. For example, you grow very fast, pubic hair appears, hormones are surging through your body, which is then followed by changes in cognitive function. For example, abstract thinking, your memory becomes more developed, and it ends when social emotional functions are taking place. So for example, you become more independent from your parents and you become more influenced by your peers. This process is accompanied at the same time by brain maturation, which starts early in adolescence with the posterior and inferior parts of the brain. And this ends around the age of 25 when the frontal lobes have matured and executive function has fully developed. When young people with ongoing or long-term health problems or psychosocial problems need more care and they turn 18, this required a transition from pediatric services into adult services. This transfer of pediatric services to adult services in most countries takes place around the age of 18. This requires careful planning and preparation, which can be an uncertain time for young, vulnerable people like individuals with 22q11 deletion syndrome. There is evidence, for example, of service gaps between child and adolescent mental health services and adult mental health services. And this gives a risk of young people failing to engage with services if they do not receive proper support at that time. A lack of continuity of care can be a disruptive experience, particularly during adolescence when young people are at increased risk of mental health problems, and then particularly people with 22q11 deletion syndrome, because they are already at increased risk of mental health problems. Transition planning requires a timely and stepwise approach, starting from puberty, that attends to each of the multidimensional needs of the individual with 22q11 deletion syndrome. Ongoing mental and physical health monitoring is essential, and coordinating multidisciplinary care should involve the family healthcare provider and necessary adult specialist, with transfer of care organized primarily by pediatric providers. Other fundamental transition components include education or vocational training, employment and housing. Caregivers and/or relevant agencies may facilitate the acquisition and maintenance of employment and/or voluntary work opportunities, all of which can enhance schedule, routine, mental and physical health, and self-esteem as well. Optimal independent living situations support community integration and functional independence while maintaining safety. Other considerations include legal guardianship, ideally already initiated prior to the age of 18 years, and medical benefits where universal healthcare is unavailable. So in conclusion, the transition to adulthood is a process accompanied by many changes around leaving school, leaving parental home, starting daytime activities, and sexual relationships. At the same time, the brain is still developing until achieving maturity around the age of 25 years. With regard to the transfer of care, start discussing the transfer early, but at the latest at the age of 16 years. Talk about what is needed from adult services. A multidisciplinary approach is needed for individuals with long-term healthcare needs, such as people with 22q11 deletion syndrome. Because of the high risk of mental health problems during the transitional phase, careful monitoring of early signs of mental disorders is necessary. We have come now at the end of this MOOC. We hope you enjoyed watching and found it useful.